पग प्यारे दंगल 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 सूरज तेरा चढ़ता ढलता गर्दिश में करते हैं तारे दंगल 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 दंगल. Great morning, my dear friends. Bhupesh Anand this side. I'm a qualified chartered accountant, qualified company secretary, qualified cost accountant, and I have a diploma in IFRS London, and I'm doing so many international courses. So today I will be starting with lecture number 4, the most important lecture, which will build your foundation for the coming study sessions. And in this lecture, I will be dealing with what are the different types of cost. I will be dealing with average variable cost. I will be dealing with variable cost, fixed cost, average fixed cost, total cost, average total cost, marginal cost, and their relationship between each other. So today's lecture is the most important lecture. Please take out your registers and start writing lecture number 4. Lecture number 4, action speaks louder than words, prerequisites for CFA level 1 economics. We have already covered 4 lectures in this, you know, that is demand and supply analysis, firm structure. Now today is the 4th lecture in this reading, and I will be covering with learning outcome number D. It means I have covered A, I have covered B, I have covered C. This is the learning outcome number D, that is total cost. What I mean by total cost, what I mean by average cost, what I mean by marginal cost, total cost, average cost, marginal cost. So when I say total cost, it is composite of 2 costs. One is variable and second is fixed. So we will be seeing the nature of fixed cost. Firstly, what is fixed cost? What is total fixed cost? What is fixed cost per unit? Then graphically, and then the nature of that, whether it will decrease or increase with the same level of production. Similarly, variable cost. What is the nature of variable cost? What are the examples of variable cost? And whether it will increase or decrease. And that, what is variable cost per unit and what is total variable cost? And when I total this total average variable cost with fixed cost, it is named as total cost. The first point you will start writing down, that is fixed cost. Please note down, please prepare your class notes, it is important. Fixed cost, as the name indicates, fixed, the cost which remains same irrespective of the level of production, that is named as fixed cost. For example, rent of, you know, factory rent, depreciation of machineries, salaries to be paid, all that cost which does not vary, you know, along with production, that remain fixed irrespective of production. Whether you are producing anything or whether you are not producing anything, whether you are producing up to 0% or maximum up to installed capacity, the cost will remain same. That cost is named as fixed cost. So please write an A point. Those costs which do not vary directly with the quantity produced, it means with the quantity produced, they will not directly vary, that are named as fixed cost. Rent, salaries, depreciation on plant and machinery, etc. Now the point is, what is the meaning of total fixed cost? When I say total fixed cost remains same, but fixed cost per unit will decline as I increase number of units produced. As I increase my number of units produced, my fixed cost per unit will decline. So see, in B example I have given that let the fixed cost be $10,000. Now if I produce one unit, then also I am incurring total fixed cost as $10,000. If I am producing 2 units, 10 units, 100 units, supposingly my maximum installed capacity is 1000 units. Still then I am incurring 10,000 as a fixed cost. So see, in the nature of fixed cost per unit, that is decreasing. Firstly 10,000, then 1000, then 100, and then 10. So that is fixed cost per unit. This is total fixed cost, and this is units of production. So please write down and note down this example. Please, total fixed cost remains same, but fixed cost per unit declines as there is increase in production. It means total fixed cost will remain same, but fixed cost per unit will decline as I increase the number of units produced. My fixed cost per unit will decline. So see, the graph I have prepared for you. On x-axis I have taken quantity, on y-axis I have taken price. This is total fixed cost which is parallel to x-axis. That is $10,000. If I assume that my total fixed cost will be $10,000. So this is $10,000. It will remain same irrespective of production. Fixed cost per unit is decreasing as my level of production is increasing. Just see, fixed cost per unit is being decreasing. Just see here also, 10,000, 1,110. So as an analyst, I should be aware of which type of cost, what is the nature of that, what is the classification of that, how we treat it in real life. So first point is, I have to, you know, today I have to tell you these three concepts. One is the total cost. Firstly, I will be telling you total cost. Within this, I will be telling you fixed cost, and then variable cost, and then the total of these two, total cost, and then average variable cost, then average fixed cost, and then average total cost. And then last, I will tell you the nature of marginal cost, and I will draw all the three curves. Very simple. So first point, which I have discussed just now, is fixed cost. Fixed cost is that cost which remain fixed whether you produce or not produce. It means it will remain same up to that installed capacity level. That is named as fixed cost. And fixed cost per unit declines as I increase my level of production. Okay. So let's move to next part of cost, that is variable cost. As the name indicates, vary. The cost which varies with the production. If I increase the production, my cost will increase. Raw material cost, labor cost, that cost will increase. And if I decrease the production, my cost will decrease. That type of cost is named as variable cost. So second point, those types of costs which are directly related with quantity produced. I am telling you about variable cost. Those types of cost like direct material, direct labor, direct expenses, those types of cost which are directly related to production with quantity produced are named as variable cost. For example, raw material, labor cost, and these are my variable costs. So what is total cost? Very simple. Fixed cost, I have told you that this is fixed cost, that it will remain same. This is variable cost. Now fixed cost plus variable cost, if I total it, it is total cost. Total cost. So please write in the formula, total fixed cost plus total variable cost is total cost. Now how to draw it graphically, that is very important, you know. So I have taken x-axis quantity demanded, and on y-axis I have taken price. Just see, firstly I have drawn total fixed cost, which is parallel to x-axis. Then I have drawn total variable cost. Just see, firstly it is increasing, then decreasing, and then increasing. It means we cannot say that variable cost will always remain, variable cost per unit will always remain same. No. It can increase or it can decrease, but firstly it will decrease and then it will increase. I will tell you the reason that why total variable cost firstly decreases and then increases. And very simple, this total cost, that is total of variable cost, total variable cost plus total fixed cost, that is equal to total cost. So just see, x-axis quantity, y-axis price. Firstly, I have drawn total variable cost, then I have drawn total cost, and total cost is the total of total variable plus total fixed. So that is total cost. So this point is very important. Please write down. It is not important that there has to be a linear relationship. It means it is not important that whenever I increase the production, my variable cost will increase. To some extent, sometimes it decreases also. The linear relationship, it means variable cost per unit might increase or might decrease, you know. Just see here in the graph, just see, even if I see in the Google, that just see, variable cost is firstly decreasing and then increasing. Variable cost is firstly decreasing and then increasing. This is average fixed cost. This is variable cost. Okay, I want to show you, I will not show you firstly the average part, rather I will be showing you total variable cost. Okay, okay, this is total variable cost, this is fixed cost. Just see, the fixed cost is parallel to x-axis, and then total variable cost, firstly it is decreasing and then it is increasing. Firstly it is decreasing and then increasing, and just see the total cost. You know, the total cost is a total of total fixed cost plus total variable cost. But just see the distance here. The distance here is how much, and the distance here, you know, the distance in this area and this area is same, but the distance here, that is the distance between total cost and total variable cost, and total cost and total variable cost, the distance here is lower than distance here, this distance. I will tell you what is the relevance for that. So I think you must be preparing the graph. Please prepare it, my dear friend. I have told you, I have shown you the correct picture. Now, no doubt it is, it, I have drawn it by hand. It may not give you that impression, but for that I have shown you this Google Baba. Just see again. Please prepare as per this Google Baba. X-axis is quantity, y-axis is cost, price, and this is total fixed cost. Just see the variable cost, just see the total cost. Now total cost will start from where total fixed cost will be there, because if there is zero units produced, then variable cost will be zero, but total fixed cost will still be entered, because total fixed cost is always fixed. It is irrespective of production. So total cost, total variable cost, total fixed cost. It is not important that there has to be really linear relationship. It means variable cost per unit might increase or decrease at some stage. Now, so I have discussed three types of cost, my dear sir. First is I have discussed total fixed cost, then I have discussed variable cost, and then I have discussed total cost. Now I am on to second concept, that is average cost. How to calculate average? It is very simple. When I say average, it means total variable cost divided by number of units produced. Average fixed cost, total fixed cost divided by number of units produced. Average total cost, total cost divided by number of units produced. That is named as average. So just see, just write down, start writing down something about average. Average cost. Now, average cost is composite of three, you know, three. I will be discussing three headings within average cost. One is average variable cost. Second is average fixed cost. And third is average total cost. So, average variable cost. It is variable cost per unit of output. Again, I am telling you, when I say average, it means I am calculating average. How I can calculate average? Total variable cost divided by total number of units produced. That will be average cost. You are getting my point? So if I want to calculate average variable cost, then total variable cost divided by number of units produced, the balancing figure will be average cost per unit. So write down fifth point, average variable cost. It is variable cost per unit of output. It first decreases and then increases. It first decreases and then increases. It first decreases and then increases with greater quantities. It means this cost, you know, firstly it will increase and then firstly, just see, firstly it is decreasing. Firstly it will decrease and then it will increase with the greater quantities. I will show you this point. You have to remember that average variable cost will firstly decrease and then increase with the greater quantity because of two reasons. The first reason I have shown you the diminishing marginal productivity and diseconomies of scale. This can be diseconomies of scale. And second is diminishing margin of returns. For example, in festival season, you know, when I increase my production, you know, I have to appoint seasonal labor and I have to pay more to them. So when my production increases in the festival season, in the Diwali season, in the Raksha Bandhan, in each season, I have to pay more. In that case, my per unit average variable cost will increase. But firstly, it will decrease and then it will increase. Now, why it increases? It increases due to so many reasons. First point is due to diseconomies of scale. And second reason is due to diminishing return of productivity. I have told you that whenever you are employing more number of workers, the output will decline, because there is a law named as diminishing marginal productivity. That my productivity will decline if I employ more number of laborers. So I have told you about average variable cost. So please write down about average fixed cost. It is fixed cost per unit of output. It is fixed cost per unit of output and declines with greater quantities of output. Please write down. It is fixed cost per unit of output. When I say average fixed cost, it means total fixed cost upon number of units. Now it will decline. I have shown you that example, that when total fixed cost is 10,000 and if I want to calculate per unit, then it will decline as my production increases. My fixed cost per unit will decline. So write down 6 point. It is fixed cost per unit of output and declines with greater quantities of output. Okay, now very simple. When I have discussed average variable cost, when I have discussed average fixed cost, now what is average total cost? Average variable cost plus average fixed cost, that is average total cost. So it is the total cost per unit of output and it is equal to average fixed cost plus average variable cost. Very simple. Average fixed cost plus average variable cost. Just see the graph which I have prepared. Very important for you. X-axis. When I say price, you know, it means cost also. X-axis, just see, I have taken quantity, and in y-axis I have taken price or cost. Firstly see average fixed cost. I have told you that average fixed cost per unit will firstly, you know, it will decline as the number of units being produced. And second is average variable cost. It will firstly decline and then it will increase because of diseconomies of scale and marginal diminishing productivity. So when I add average variable cost and average fixed cost, the total will be average total cost. Now, why average total cost firstly declines and then increases? Just see, firstly average total cost is declining. Firstly average total cost is declining and then it is increasing, as in case of average variable cost also. So the point is, you know, it is declining because if you see the distance, you know, this distance of fixed cost and this distance, the above distance is more, it means it will decline. But as we move further, just see this distance between the average variable cost and average total cost, this distance has become some smaller as compared to here. There is a larger distance, there is a smaller distance. So there can be 2-3 reasons for that why average total cost firstly decreases and then increases. So please prepare this graph, my dear friend. It is very important that you should prepare it. I will be showing you accurate figure from Google Baba. Actually, I have prepared that very accurately, but still, just have a look in this. Just see. This is average fixed cost. The first curve is average fixed cost as I am going in increasing production. The second is average variable cost. And the third is average total cost. Just see the distance here, the distance here, and the distance here. Or I will show you this point here also, that how much is the distance, you know. That distance is important. Okay, I have seen it. I will show you. Yes, I think you must have prepared this. So let's move to next point. So this I have discussed about average cost. Now, what are the interpretations for that? These are testable in the examination and you should write down all the interpretations. These are important. The first interpretation is the vertical difference between ATC and ABC. That is average total cost and average fixed variable cost. It means the distance between the average total cost and average variable cost is of average fixed cost. This is very simple. We know that average variable cost plus average fixed cost is equal to average total cost. So what is the distance between average total cost and average variable cost? That distance is average fixed cost. Second point, average fixed cost is decreasing. I have shown you. Average fixed cost is decreasing. Just see, average fixed cost is decreasing. Average fixed cost is decreasing. Average fixed cost is decreasing as I am producing more number of units. Okay, so what is the interpretation for that? As quantity produces increasing, as long as I am not planning to buy a new plant or a machinery, this will decrease. Okay, C point, average variable cost Now, what is our average variable cost? Firstly, the average variable cost will decrease and then it will increase. So, see point, average variable cost in the initial stage of manufacturing, in the initial stage of manufacturing will decline in average, but after some time, you know, due to diseconomies of scale and due to marginal diminishing productivity, it will start increasing. Okay, average total cost, there will be decline in ATC and then it will increase again. ATC will decline and then it will increase, and there are two, three reasons for that. The first reason is the distance between, firstly the distance was wider, you know, and then the distance was very smaller. Just see, reason A, fixed cost per unit and variable cost per unit are decreasing. Because at beginning, fixed cost per unit is in decreasing as I increase the production, and variable cost is also decreasing firstly, because it is only after that it will increase. So because both are decreasing, and hence it ought to be that every total cost will decrease. But then fixed cost is decreasing, but variable cost is increasing. And the distance of FA, average fixed cost, you know, that is very smaller as compared to the average variable cost. So it tend to amounts to increase in average total cost. So just write on reason A, fixed cost per unit and variable cost per unit are decreasing. And the distance, reason B, the distance between ATC and AVC is higher, then this distance is lower. Okay, last concept of today's lecture is marginal cost. So I have told you what is the meaning of total cost. Within that, I have told you total variable cost, total fixed cost, total cost. Then I have told you average variable cost, average fixed cost, average total cost. Now I want to marginal cost, and then I will be discussing the nature of marginal cost, that what is marginal cost and how it will cut the other cost, at which point it will intersect. At which point it will intersect. So next point is marginal cost. Marginal cost is increase in total variable cost or total cost. Marginal cost is increase in the total variable cost for one more additional unit of output. I have already told you in marginal revenue, the revenue which I am generating by selling one more unit, that is marginal revenue. And similarly, for producing one more unit of output, that is named as marginal cost. So just see the example. Suppose for producing 10 units, total variable cost is $150, and for producing 11 units, I have to incur $164. It means for producing one more unit, I have to incur $14, and that $14 is the marginal cost. Suppose for producing 10 units, total variable cost is $150, and for producing 11 units, total variable cost is $164. So marginal cost is cost for producing one more unit, that is $14. Now, this point is very, very highly important and highly testable. So, it is my request to you that please write on this ninth point. For a given level of fixed cost, marginal cost will firstly decrease. Again, the same concept. I have told you variable cost, average variable cost, firstly it will decrease, then increase. Average total cost, firstly it will increase, then decrease. And similarly, even total variable cost decrease, then increase. Total cost decrease, then increase. Similar is with marginal cost. Firstly, it will decrease and then it will increase. So for a given level of fixed cost, it means the fixed cost is same. Marginal cost will firstly decrease and then begin to increase. Now, why so? I have given the example. An entity is producing existing level of 10 units at the rate of 6 per unit. But if the entity is producing 11 units, at the rate of 55.0. So I will say the marginal cost is 5.50 rupees for one additional unit. So why it is so? That I have shown it with the help of example, with the help of curves. Just see, I have already told you that average variable cost. I have already told you average total cost. Now it is the time for marginal cost. Marginal cost is the cost which is incurred for producing one more unit of production. And just see, firstly the marginal cost is decreasing and then increasing in the pink color, and it is intersecting average variable cost and intersecting average total cost. Now see the points I have mentioned, A and B. At point A, it is intersecting average variable cost, and that is the lowest point of average variable cost. Even just see, it is intersecting average total cost at point B, and point B is the lowest of average total cost. The point which I want to tell you, that you have to remember for the examination, that marginal cost will intersect average variable cost and average total cost at their lowest values. So please firstly prepare this graph. A, B, quantity and that lower value. And last point is only these two interpretations, then you will see actual from Google Baba. Both ABC and ATC are at this minimum value when they are equal to marginal cost. It means ABC means average variable cost. ATC means average total cost. Both are at their minimum values when they are equal to marginal cost, or I can say marginal cost will intersect at the lower values. Point of intersection of marginal cost at ABC and ATC are different. So these are the two points which are to be taken care of. You know, even I have mentioned the point number A. Just see, this is the point of intersection for average variable cost, and this is the point of intersection for average total cost. So these points are also different, but marginal cost is cutting these two curves at their minimum points, and those two minimum points are different. So just for a second, I want to tell you something from this Google Baba, that how marginal cost, just see, this is a marginal cost, just see, this is fixed cost. This is fixed cost. This is average variable cost. This is average total cost. And just see, this marginal cost is intersecting this point at its lowest point, and average total cost curve also at its lowest point. But this point is different and this point is different. This point is different. Let it be A and let it be B. If I want to draw a perpendicular from this to this and this to this, I can say that these points are different. So it means marginal cost is a curve which intersect at the lowest point, and both the lowest are different and both the points are different. Be happy, be jolly, be cheerful.